Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about the various chemical properties that were exhibited by the alkyl halides, and now we are going to talk about what is the reaction of the alcoholic ammonia with that of alkyl halide. So let us talk about it. So the reaction of the alcoholic ammonia with that of the alkyl halide is basically a substitution reaction, and this kind of substitution reaction can take place unless all the hydrogen atoms of the ammonia are being replaced by a particular alkyl group. So therefore, this is what we are going to talk about, that is ammonolysis, or basically it is known as Hoffman's ammonolysis. But before understanding Hoffman's ammonolysis, let us understand what is the reaction, or what is the general reaction that takes place whenever an alkyl halide is being treated with alcoholic ammonia solution. So now let us talk about it. So talking about the general reaction, so therefore the alkyl halide that has been represented by, that is Rx, is suppose it has been treated with ammonia, that is alcoholic ammonia, and that is what I am representing over here in this way, that is. And suppose if I am making the reaction in such a manner, that is a substitution reaction would take place in such a way that is this hydrogen atom of that is this ammonia that would be replaced by that is the alkyl group of the alkyl halide. So therefore, in this case, we could say that this X along with this of this H atom of ammonia that would be removed in the form of HX. And the only thing that we could obtain over here is basically R over here, and this is basically NH2. So this is what we have obtained over here as alkylamine, or basically we could call it as a primary alkylamine. So therefore I would write it over here as so this is the general reaction when that is one mole of that is alkyl halide is treated with one mole of ammonia, and this is what we get over here. But this reaction can also continue ahead. The reason behind that is because the hydrogen of the ammonia, because there is three hydrogen that ammonia consists of, and that are so much capable that they can undergo that is substitution, and that's the reason that three alkyl group at least they could that is replace the hydrogen atoms of the ammonia, and not only three but even a quaternary ammonium can also be formed. So that is what I'm going to mention about, but let us understand it first, that is what is the general reaction whenever an alkyl halide is been treated with that of an alcoholic ammonia. So let us talk about it. So talking about the first example, it is very easy to talk about, that is whenever the methyl chloride or methyl bromide, if methyl chloride is been treated with that of the ammonia, that is NH3, I would write here in a structural form so that it would be easy for us to understand, that is how the reaction has been occurred and how the substitution reaction that takes place over here. So therefore we could say that is whenever an methyl chloride is been treated with that of an alcoholic ammonia, then this hydrogen along with that of this Cl, so that would be removed in the form of the byproduct, that is HCl over here. And the thing that we could obtain over here is basically CH3NH2. So the name of this reactant that we have used is basically chloromethane, and the product that we have got over here is basically methanamine. So this is what we have got over here. But if we need a primary alkylamine, so the thing that we have to do is we have to take that is the ammonia in excess, and that's the reason only that we could get the primary alkyl amine. The reason behind that is I am saying because if we use that is alkyl halide in excess, and if we use alcoholic ammonia in less quantity, then what will happen is all the hydrogen atoms that are been associated with that of ammonia, so as to make ammonia, that would be replaced by the alkyl groups, and that is how we won't get the primary alkyl amine only. In fact, we can get primary alkylamine, secondary alkyl, tertiary and quaternary also. So therefore, we could get a mixture of the alkylamines, and that is we can also prevent it by using excess amount of ammonia while we are going to react it with that is of a limited amount of alkyl chloride or alkyl halide. So this is what we could obtain, that is methanamine. So even this reaction can be possible so as to obtain that is ethanamine. The only thing we have to do is we have to take an ethyl chloride, ethyl bromide or ethyl iodide, and we have to react it with the excess amount of alcoholic that is ammonia, and then only we'll get that is ethanamine. So this is what we have over here, and this is the general reaction to obtain that is primary alkylamine. So now let us move on to the next one, and let's see that what happens if we take that is alkyl halide in an excess quantity and we treat it with alcoholic ammonia. So let us see. So considering the alkyl halide to be present in an excess amount, so therefore I would write the general reaction over here as, suppose if I am talking about that is Rx, which is in excess, suppose. If that has been treated with that of ammonia, that is NH3. So the reaction takes place in such a manner that is, we could get it over here as, we'll use alcoholic NH3, and the thing that we could obtain over here is basically RNH2 along with that of that is HCl. So the thing that we have obtained over here is basically it is known as primary alkylamine, or we could call it as this one also. And talking about the next one, that is since we have taken that is Rx or alkyl halide in an excess amount, so again this RNH2 that has been produced, even that would be reacted with that of the alkyl halide. So therefore I'm just making this reaction to be written over here, because it will act like it reacted over here, that is RNH2, and it will react with that of that is Rx. So again, a substitution reaction will take place over here, and in this case, basically one of the H of that is the primary alkyl amine that would be replaced by that of that is an alkyl group. So therefore, one of the H and one of the X that would be again removed in the form of that is HX. I have mentioned here, suppose Cl. So suppose if you consider Cl, even that would be the byproduct. So now let us mainly focus upon what is the product that we could get over here. So therefore, we'll get that is RN. Here H will be remaining, while the next here it is R. So therefore, this is known as secondary alkyl amine, and this is what we have. So now let us see what happens when this secondary alkyl amine is being treated with that of again Rx. So again, the product that we could get over here is as a byproduct, that is HX along with that of that is RN. So this is the product that we have, and this is basically known as tertiary alkylamine. But the reaction doesn't stop over here. Yes, because this tertiary alkylamine that is that would again be reacted with that of the that is alkyl halide, and so as to form a quaternary alkyl amine. So that is what we could represent over here also. So this is what we will get over here, that is a quaternary alkyl ammonium chloride halide. That is what we could say. So this kind of reaction that we have mentioned over here is basically known as Hoffman's ammolysis. Or basically it could also be called as that is alkylation of ammonia. So this is what we have, and this is what the general reaction of the alkyl that is of alkylation of ammonia means, or we could also call it as Hoffman's ammolysis. So this is what the general reaction is, and now let us talk about an example related to this one. So now let us understand the Hoffman's ammolysis with the help of an example. So let me consider the example, like suppose if I am taking the alkyl halide in excess, so therefore like suppose C2H5Cl. So the name of this is basically ethyl chloride, and suppose if I am reacting it with N that is in excess amount, so let me mention it over here also. And suppose if I am reacting it with ammonia, that is, if if I mention over here in this way, along we should also mention that is the ammonia that is alcoholic, it is basically alcoholic ammonia. And the reaction would take place in such a manner that is a separation reaction would take place and H along with this Cl that would be removed in the form of HCl. Then the only thing that would be remained with us is basically this alkyl group, or basically this, especially this ethyl group along with that of this NH2. So therefore, the thing is CH2NH2. So this is what we have left with. And this is basically known as ethanamine, or we could also call it as ethylamine. So this is basically an example of a primary amine, or we could call it as 1-degree amine, and this is the 1-degree alkyl amine that we have. And now, but since we have talked about that the ethyl chloride that has been present in excess amount, so therefore this is the product that we have got in the first step. And again, this would be reacted with that of the ethyl chloride, and let us see what is the reaction that we could form. So that is C2H5 along with that of this NH2. It will be reacted with that of that is C2H5Cl. And the thing is, again a reaction will happen in such a way that is again a substitution reaction will take place over here, and one of the H and along with that of one Cl that will be removed in the form of that is HCl. And the only thing that would be left out is basically C2H5, NHC2H5. So the name of this product that we have opted over here is basically because, as you could see, that is there are two ethyl groups that have been attached to this ammonia group. So we have basically two ethyl groups along with that of this ammonia group, and so the name of this one would be called as that is diethyl amine. But the reaction doesn't stop over here, and this is basically known as secondary amine. Well, the first one, the first product that we have got over here is basically known as primary amine, and now we have got secondary amine. Again, this is the ammoniolysis that has taken place over here, and now the reaction doesn't stop over here, and again this diethylamine will be further reacted with the excess amount of that is C2H5Cl, basically ethyl chloride. So let us see what is the product that we could form. So therefore, the product that we have obtained in the second step, that is, it is diethylamine. So now it will be reacted with that of the excess amount of that is ethyl chloride. So let us see what is the product that we could get. So that is, suppose C2H5, here it is N, here it is H, and here it is basically C2H5. And again, suppose if it has been treated with that of that is ethyl chloride, so we could write it over here as that is C2H5Cl. And now let us see. We are performing that is ammoniolysis, and in this case again a substitution reaction will take place over here, where one of the hydrogen of this diethylamine that would be replaced with that of C2H5 over here. But meanwhile, we could say that this hydrogen and this chlorine atom that would be removed in the form of that is HCl. So the product that we could get over here is basically, I could write it over here as C2H5N, here it is C2H5, and here it is C2H5. The name of the product that we have opted over here is basically known as triethyl amine. This is basically tertiary amine, and so this is what we have got over here. But again, the reaction doesn't stop over here, because as I mentioned earlier also, that is the reaction will go on continuing unless all of the hydrogen atoms have been completely replaced by the alkyl groups or of the alkyl halide. So now here I am again reacting it with basically suppose C2H5 and C2H5 over here, and again here it is suppose C2H5. So again it will be treated with that is the alkyl halide, that is C2H5Cl. I am mentioning over here this way. So the product that we could get over here is basically it would be C2H5 over here, and here also it will be C2H5, and here it will be C2H5 over here, and here it will be positive charge, while the halide that is present over here is basically Cl minus. So therefore a kind of a quaternary ammonium, that is what we could get over here, and the name of this is the product that we have obtained over here is basically is tetra ethyl ammonium chloride. So this is what I was talking about, and that is Hoffman's ammonolysis. So this is how we have got to know about what is the reaction between an alkyl halide along with that of an ammonia. And we have also discussed about that is what happens when an alkyl halide has been present in an excess amount compared to that of the ammonia. Or what happens if the ammonia is present in an excess amount compared to that of the alkyl halide that we are using. So this is what we have got to know about in this lecture. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know to clear your various concepts behind this one. So thank you for watching this video, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.